The Responder is a British police procedural series drama set in Liverpool, written by former Liverpool police officer Tony Schumacher. It stars Martin Freeman, Adelayo Adedayo, Ian Hart, and MyAnna Buring. Show creator Schumacher has said that the character has a lot to do with him and the struggles he faced as a police officer, but the storyline is in fact fictional. Chris Carlson is a police officer in a fictional constabulary covering Liverpool and has been demoted from his position as an inspector and undertakes a series of night shifts in central Liverpool. His work scenes are interspersed with scenes of him at therapy at home and with his mother at the nursing home. Carlson is a conflicted and compromised man with somewhat divided loyalties, a desire to do good, but by a violent and aggressive streak brought on by a childhood of trauma exacerbated by his experience in the police. The effects of the job and Chris's mental state take a toll on his family. Now, The Responder is a heavy and intense show which takes you on a journey with the policeman as he delves into the darker underworld of Liverpool. It is a well-made show and Martin Freeman is excellent as the cynical, jaded and hard-lined cop, Carlson. It shows Freeman's range as an actor, as he isn't really known for playing tough guy roles like this one. But he does this very well. MyAnna Buring is good as his wife, Kate Carlson, who's struggling with the ability to deal with her husband and the burdens of the job as they take a toll on him. Ian Hart is unrecognisable in this role and plays the irritating Carl Sweeney, a mid-level drug dealer whose stash of cocaine has been stolen by local baghead, Casey. Ian Hart is always an accomplished actor, although I can't say much for his wig in this show. Warren Brown plays Raymond Mulland, a demoted officer with an axe to grind for Chris. He plays this role well, as he has to be so obsessed with Chris and absolutely despises him in every way. I was very impressed with Adelayo Adedayo and her take on Rachel Hargreaves, a probationary police officer and later Chris's partner. She is young, naive and a do-gooder cop, trying her best to uphold the law and be a good, clean-living police officer. She's perplexed by Carson's actions and can't decide whether she likes him or hates him. She's taken on a rollercoaster ride with Chris, as in one scene you see them connecting as he helps her, to the next scene where he literally places her life in danger. She also has a complicated relationship with her boyfriend, which can be confusing and scary at times to watch play out. You do find it irritating at first, and then you quite like her. In the same breath, though, she frustrates you, as her constant back and forth with Carson rages on. Now, the characters of Casey and Marco, played by Emily Fearn and Joseph Fanan, respectively, are absolutely fascinating. You actually forget you're watching two actors, as in most British shows, they are so realistic and authentic and gritty that you almost feel like you're watching a documentary. Also, you realize how dark and seedy the underworld of these British cities can be. The one thing, though, I will say for these two is you most definitely need subtitles, as the Liverpudlian accent is very strong and hard to understand. Now, Freeman himself spent 18 months before he filmed the series talking to himself in a Scouse accent so he could perfect it. Now, as I said earlier, Freeman is superb in the show. You do believe that he's this tired, jaded cop, and it looks like Freeman literally got no sleep for the production of the show. Carson is likable to a point, but he also frustrates you, as he does the wrong things all the time and makes stupid and silly decisions. He isn't a bad cop, he just makes bad choices. For me, though, it's a show of two halves. I found the first two episodes very intense and hard-hitting, but then the story evolves quickly into a personalized drama of this cop trying to do right but going about it in the wrong way. I found the last few episodes quite rushed and unevenly paced, and then the show just kind of ends, leaving you with this sort of hollow feeling, like, isn't there supposed to be more? Sometimes I find this with British drama. They really rush to get to the point, and maybe they could have made this a 6-episode show. Unlike the American drama, where they take too long to get to the point. Gritty and intense and very well acted, I did find the ending left a lot to be desired. The Responder gets a 7 out of 10.